As much as people observe you, you remain locked within your particle existence. And when people don't observe you, you can enter into your wave reality. But for the grace of Allah that we are still in existence, Allah guides humanity, and sometimes humanity may catch up with its understanding of guidance through their sciences and through their understandings. So quantum sciences was their study of light, or what we would call the malakut, the world of eternity, that which is eternal. And when they studied the light, they understood that the reality of the duality of light, that when they darkened a room and they put out a spectrum of light, and when they watched the light in their experiment, it always went through one hole. And until one time they decided, well, maybe let's not watch it, we'll turn the other way and we won't observe it, and let's do the experiment. And to their surprise, the light went through two holes. So they understood now, their sciences started to open on the reality of the duality of light. And once, to their amazement, that light was reacting to them, it was reacting to its observation. When it deemed itself being observed, it stayed within the confine of its particle existence. When that light was not observed, it went into its wave format and was able to go through two holes when it wasn't being watched. This is an ancient reality, means Allah's realities are ancient and taught amongst the prophets and the saints towards humanity. And every so often Allah releases a permission in their sciences to understand as a guidance, to bring people towards a reality. So when they're studying that every light has a duality, has a particle and has a wave, and the tariqah comes to teach from what Prophet had brought and perfected, this science of light, this science of reality, that you have a particle existence and you have a wave existence. The particle existence is that which people observe, but the science is telling people, no, we also have a wave existence. Means you have a form of light that is moving. They barely understand where it's moving, and that's just the light of you. Imagine then the atomic reality of you, the electrons of you. How are those exactly within a very defined orbit? And what happens if you try to move one of those forcefully? Everything so defined and so perfect.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. Inshallah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments, and please share the stream every bit counts. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
For us, on this subject of the duality of light, this is the teaching of tariqah, that if you want a particle existence, this is your mulk, your form, for us to understand and make it simplified. Or do you want to train in your light reality, which we call the malakut and the heavenly reality? And everybody has these two realities, but it's based on observation. So what they understood from their sciences, this is the teachings of tariqah. As much as people observe you, you remain locked within your particle existence. And when people don't observe you, you can enter into your wave reality. So that's why then the tariqahs come and teach people that be nothing. So this concept of be nothing was so that they could reach their reality. Means that you have these two realities, but if you're not opening them, your understanding is only of a very physical nature, and you lose the whole concept of your spirituality. You lose the whole possibility of your spirituality. Means the potential of our understanding within the wave reality, the light reality of insan and people is limitless, because we still don't know what Allah has created. How many infinite creations and galaxies and universes, and how much of that light of yours exists within that galaxies and those universes. And if all of those are under Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one who knows himself will know his reality, know his Lord, and will enter into the Muhammadan light that encompasses every aspect of this universe. Not only the dunya, not only the universe, but everything within the heavens. Every angel is in a Muhammadan light. If Prophet give to you access within the light, that within the reality of not only finding yourself but entering into the Muhammadan light, that you can enter your light into the reality of the different malaika to understand their reality. So if everything has a light, and they're teaching that this is all a Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. By knowing yourself, you'll know your Lord, and means you'll know what governs you. You have the potential of ever entering into every aspect of light, from all its planets and all its universes and all of that, all the way into the sama and into the heavens. From into the heavens, Baytul Mahmud, into the arsh, into the angels, into everything that is created by that light. Take a light, you shine another light, and you see how that light diffuses within the light and it enters into it. If Prophet gives you the code to go, that I allow your light to move within my light to understand everything. That it's all created from his reality sallallahu alaihi wasallam, means then the potential and the limit is limitless. And that's why it's a timeless reality. If we stick within the confines of time and particle and form, very limited dunya, very limited existence, life that doesn't even touch a drop of its reality. And so then Allah was sending guidance from the heavens to teach them your duality, but didn't use these scientific words. Taught them be nothing. Why? Escape the observation of people. So the tariqah comes and teaches you have these two realities, everyone has these two realities. But if you're raised in a way that you want to show yourself, identify yourself, propagate yourself, Facebook yourself, Instagram yourself, what's shaitan doing? He's making sure you're completely under observation, right? Because he knows these two theories. He knows that this person will never reach their reality if they're under observation. So now 99% of all creation is making themselves more observed. Even some guy in the middle of a village of anywhere, he has a mobile phone for some reason and he's posting himself where nobody would have observed him. Shaitan plays with him that observe, let people to observe you, you will never reach your destiny. So then taruqs come and teach, if we know that this law and this reality that if you're under observation, you're held by that observation, right? If 10 eyes are looking at you, you're held by it, you didn't reach your reality. You're just held by their observation is like frozen you from achieving anything. So tariqahs would come and Prophet was teaching, be nothing. Be nothing, hide yourself and move yourself from the eye of people. Blessed are those whom understood to hide their reality, because tariqah training is not that you become a particle and then propagate your particle, you'll never reach your reality. And the particle's power is very limited to its material understanding. Only through your wave, if you're trained through your wave reality where you broke it, you broke the observation that you isolated and secluded yourself from the eyes of people and the eyes of observation, your light is moving into their realms, into their hearts and into their souls and into the oceans of realities and knowledges which are called Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
A Timeless Reality with Shaykh Nurjan Mirahmadi guides the reader in meditation, connecting the heart to a guide and to daily spiritual practices to understand the effects of positive and negative energy and to progress the reader in their spiritual awakening and the soul's connection to the world of light. The Divine's Ancient Timeless Reality. Order on Amazon.com.
Each shaykh is a custodian of a Muhammadan secret, each secret separate from the other, no two secrets are the same. This is azimatullah. Allah doesn't recycle, because I have to have two secrets, one for you because I'm short on secrets. Each reality Allah uniquely different than the other, and all of them its key is Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Only through the wave reality means that only through casting your light into that ocean and into that reality you can begin to move through it, because that light is an energy and energy is not destroyable. An energy picks up its residue everywhere it goes, right? So the light bulb here we're talking, the energy here says, I went into a light bulb, I experienced that. I went into a nuclear power plant, I experienced that. I went into a mobile phone, I went into a TV, it's the same electricity, just moving and experiencing everything that Allah wants it to experience, but it picks up the residue of what it experienced, it keeps the knowledge of what it experienced. Now the light, which is far superior than electricity, is that When you enter into your wave reality and your light reality, your light goes everywhere. It's diffused into everything. Based on that, you are like a Google, that whatever you're asking from that light, it's moving. Now they understood in their computers they want to do that. They want to make your computer into a node, into a hub. And they want to take everything off of your information and your database and your hard drives, and they want to use a billion computers for computing, not one computer. Allah said, already we had this long time ago. Means that if you move through your soul, you're moving through the light of everything. And wherever it moves, they go, they move into your heart and into your soul. You're not encrypted, you're not locked. And through your heart and soul, they know what you're wanting and what you're asking. You're happy, you're sad, you're mad, you're glad. It's all written on your lights, you're not hiding it. And whether that's why they say, oh, when we log on, we ask the question, we already got the answer. Or the one who gave you the question and the one answering you is the same, it's all from the heavens. It's all been already established on a world of light. And those whom operating from that light, they're just sort of moving within that dimension. What knowledge has to be brought, the light moves into it, picks it, and immediately by the speed of thought and light, that light is retrieving that knowledge back. So it means everything is happening in the wave reality. If the student achieves their wave reality, they achieve everything. What they would call ulumul awwaleen wa akhireen, why? Because once you achieve your way of reality, there's no limit to where Allah will send that light. That's only based on Allah. If He allows the darajat of the light, that light now is getting more powerful, we're allowing it to go into this realm. They can talk above the maqam of Sayyidina Jibreel as salam. Because their light is penetrating even deeper and deeper and deeper, and as a result of penetrating, they're retrieving all the information through their light. And that's how this system operates. So when people come and sit, no matter through TV, video, this doesn't mean anything, we're talking about the seven heavens and above. What does a video and somebody sitting in Alabama have anything to do with it? That's so much more easier than what they're describing. As soon as people are sitting, their light is sending a signal, their data of the light of the shaykh is moving through all of them and picking up every signal and every necessity. Where their light is coming short is putting in, where their light is in excess, what they need to know, what they need to be protected from. That system is flowing, and the one who reached the wave, it's not him, he's nothing. In his training to be nothing, he represented something. And in their nothingness, they can achieve immense, immense realities. Because the one whom is sending the signal is reaching to everyone. So it means that madad that they teach, the madad addressing them, the madad of all of these huge souls, their lights are flowing through them and reaching to everyone's code, reaching what they're in need of, not what they're asking from, what they're in need of. Because with the asking, we said before, is what we would call a terrorist, but the computer is going to pick up a NSA. Your bad character inflicts terror upon your soul. The one who's talking all the time is the ego. They're not listening to egos and seeing what the ego has a question, the ego has this, the ego has a concern, the ego has a complaint. My goodness, that's not the way anyone would operate from the heavens. They're operating from the soul, right? They just need you to be humble enough to come forward, to participate. Your soul is communicating with their light and saying that this zalim is doing this, this like this, this like this. and the coordinates are coming and the najat is moving, the lights are flowing, the whatever realities have to be bestowed are happening. So then that's why the teaching was, be nothing. Leave your particle existence, it achieves nothing, it benefits no one. Lot of particle talking but they can't reach anything or do anything. So the tariqahs come and teach that you have to be a wave. And all of the adab of tariqah is don't look to other people what you think they are or what they're thinking or not. But just understand the teaching from the shaykh is that you have to be nothing. You have to have achieved your wave reality. Means it's been buried, it's been buried, it's been buried. They're not visible anywhere, we're not visible on any photo. They had an existence in which was non-existent, they didn't sign up to be existent. They wanted to reach to the presence of Prophet and the tariqahs come and teach that if you reach to that wave in which you isolate yourself and reach and find your character, make your muraqabah, make your connection, don't look left and right and say, I want to be like that, I want to be like this, I want to be like nothing. They would go and I told the gentleman, when they go to see a shaykh, they see him at his end state. So, look, shaykh is talking everywhere, I want to be like that, I talk everywhere, I give everybody answers that mean nothing. No, no, look to the shaykh when he was training, not when he's in the position of his guidance. How was he trained? He was in no pictures. He paid for everything but he was not seen on anything. You can't find him in anything. He didn't want to be identified as anything. Look to their character, what they were, how they got to where they got to go. Means that when they trained to be a wave, everything was broken down, they achieved a wave status and each wave may be even stronger than the other. But they have to be a wave and only through their wave reality they'll be recruited by Prophet ﷺ. Doesn't matter what anyone says, you're this, you're that, you're khalifa this, you're khalifa that, this, that's all their own stuff. None of those titles matter until they're recruited by Prophet ﷺ. That your wave status is achieved and as a result you talk. Because of the strength that you have in your wave reality, with the ijazah we give you to talk, they're particle form won't be confined by the eyes of people because they achieve the light, they achieve the wave. If you don't achieve the wave and you put yourself as particle, their eyes will lock you and you'll speak out what you memorized. But the reality of wave and malakut is that you achieve the light and it reached to them. And your light free to move in their wave format in any place, at any time, at anywhere. If you achieve that nothingness, Allah opens for you the science of it. Because a wave only moves as a wave when it's not observed. And you don't have the power of the observation until you're mature. So when you isolate, you've gone into another first rule, you're not under observation. But the angels are watching you and that's when Allah wants clarification, what's their character? They have to reach to a level of purity in which their character has sincerity and Allah begin then to unlock. On which Allah tained the angels that this one, this rijal is sincere and no longer you have to observe that individual. He will be responsible to observe himself and as a result he can enter his wave format at any time and the angels don't lock him to be under observation. We pray that Allah dress us and bless us from the immensity of what Allah has given. Wa laqad karamna bani adam. When an order comes from Prophet that this one is going to be in the training of nothingness. And when they achieve that nothingness then Imam Ali Salam has to sign its certificate of sainthood. And this is from Imam al-Rahbani in the Naqshbandi tariqah confirming, We pray that Allah dress us, bless us with the immensities of the tariqah, the immensity of what Allah has given to this Muhammadan kingdom inshaAllah. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa, bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of divinely knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide. From feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.